In order to add numbers in scientific notation, the exponents must be the same. So as you can see here, the exponents are not the same. The first one, the exponent is a 3. The second one, the exponent is a 4. So we need to increase the exponent with the 3, and we can make them the same. Or you could decrease the exponent for the second one, but why don't we increase the first one? So to increase the exponent, we want to move the decimal here to the left. So we need to increase this by 1, so we're going to move the decimal 1 to the left. So we have 0.32 times 10 to the 4th now, plus 1.4 times 10 to the 4th. So now we have the same exponents, and now we can add these numbers. Once the exponents are the same, we're going to keep them the same. So we're going to add 0.32 plus 1.4, and then we're going to keep that exponent the same. So 0.32 plus 1.4 equals 1.72, and then we have times 10 to the 4th. So this is our final answer. To add numbers in scientific notation, the exponents must be the same. As you can see, these exponents are not the same. One is 2 and the other is 3. So why don't we change the 2 to a 3 in the first number, and then the exponents will be the same, and then we'll keep that exponent. So in order to increase an exponent, we need to move the decimal to the left. So since we need to increase this by 1, we're going to move the decimal 1 to the left. That's going to give us 0.18 times 10 to the 3rd now. And then we still have the second one that's the same, plus 3.51 times 10 to the 3rd. Now that we have the same exponent, we're going to keep that exponent, and we're going to add the numbers. So 0.18 plus 3.51 equals 3.69, and then we're going to keep that exponent the same. So the final answer is 3.69 times 10 to the 3rd. To subtract numbers in scientific notation, the exponents must be the same. As you can see here, they are not the same. The first exponent is a 2, the second exponent is a 1. So why don't we increase the exponent in the second number by adding 1? And if we do that, that means that we need to move the decimal point to the left 1. So that means the first one will stay the same, 2.3 times 10 to the 2nd minus 0.165 times 10 to the 2nd. So now that we have the same exponents, now we can subtract the numbers. 2.3 minus 0.165 equals 2.135. And we're going to keep the same exponents. So then we can write our final answer as 2.135 times 10 to the 2nd power. And remember that we want scientific notation in our final answer. So the number needs to be between 1 and 10 here. To subtract numbers in scientific notation, the exponents must be the same. As you can see here, the exponents are not the same. The first exponent is negative 4, the second exponent is negative 5. So if we want to make them be the same, we need to change one of the numbers. So why don't we change the first number? And so if we want to turn this negative 4 into negative 5, that means we need to subtract 1. And if we subtract 1 in the exponent, that means we need to move the decimal 1 to the right. So then this becomes 74 times 10 to the negative 5 minus 3.6 times 10 to the negative 5. Now that we have the same exponents, we can now subtract the numbers. So 74 minus 3.6 equals 70.4. So right now we have 70.4 times 10 to the negative 5 because we keep that exponent. But as you can see, this is not in scientific notation. We need to move this decimal in 70.4 one to the left so it can be between the numbers 1 and 10, which will give us 7.04. But if we move the decimal 1 to the left, we need to add 1 in our exponent. So our exponent now becomes 10 to the negative 4. So the final answer is 7.04 times 10 to the negative 4. To multiply numbers in scientific notation, the exponents do not need to be the same. So it's completely fine. We do not need to change the exponents here just because they're different. So all we need to do is simply multiply the numbers and then add the exponents. So let's go for it. 4.1 times 3.0 equals 12.3. So we have 12.3 times, and then we're going to add the exponents, 7 plus 5. So we have 12.3 times 10 to the 12th power. But we know that this is not in scientific notation because 12.3 is not between 1 and 10. So we need to move the decimal 1 to the left. And if we move the decimal to the left 1, that means we need to increase the exponent by 1. So then the final answer will be 1.23 times 10 to the 13th power. To multiply numbers in scientific notation, the exponents do not need to be the same. So all we have to do is multiply the numbers and then add the exponents. So 5 times 2.5 equals 12.5. So we have 12.5 times 10 to the, add the exponents. So that's going to be 12.5 times 10 to the first. But we know that this is not in scientific notation because 12.5 is not between 1 and 10. So that means we're going to have to move the decimal in 12.5 one to the left. And if we move it one to the left, that means we need to add 1 to the exponent. So the final answer will be 1.25 times 10 to the second. In order to divide numbers in scientific notation, the exponents do not need to be the same. Simply divide the numbers and subtract the exponents. So let's start by dividing these numbers. So 8.7 divided by 1.4 equals 6.21. And then we're going to subtract the exponents. So then we're going to have 6.21 times 10 to the 3 minus 4. So that's going to give us 6.21 times 10 to the negative 1. In order to divide numbers in scientific notation, the exponents do not need to be the same, so all we need to do is divide the numbers, and then we're going to subtract the exponents. So let's get started. 5.2 divided by 1.3 equals 4. Now, we have 4 times 10 to the, and subtract the exponents. Negative 5 minus 5 gives us 10 to the negative 10. So the final answer is 4 times 10 to the negative 10.